It's so powerful to have teachers convene and discuss what they did well and what do they need to do differently, and then apply that understanding immediately.
To do data meetings, we use a framework from Relay, Graduate School of Education. It's a data analysis protocol that requires a lot of leader preparation.
We do exactly what we want the teachers to do. So I will go through the whole process. I collect the student work. I unpack the standard myself with the help of my team as a thought partner, someone to push me to make sure that my no's and do's are the best that they can be and it encompasses everything. And then I'll look at the student work and analyze the errors so that I know going into the weekly data meeting where I want to guide teachers.
It helps me prepare. It helps me to know what to look for, because I feel like you can't really execute something if you don't know what you're looking for. And so if teachers give you this exemplar response, you need to be ready, because if they give you something that's not that you haven't prepared for it, then you need to be able to have an answer for that.
Another way that I prepare for a data meeting is to actually practice the execution of the data meeting live before I get in front of teachers. And similarly to the idea that our teachers are practicing their reteach within the weekly data meeting so that they can be effective to get in front of teachers, I need to practice the execution of the weekly data meeting to then be effective in front of teachers. And being that prepared helps me facilitate that within the weekly data meeting and guide the teachers towards seeing the gap faster so that we can spend a lot of the time practicing the reteach and really making sure that they're ready to deliver that.
Today, what we're going to focus on is specifically charting for the area model. So share out some no's and do's for the area model.
So my note is, it has to be laid out correctly because I have to know the knowledge of place value.
As educators, we know that we can't actually physically get inside a student's head and figure out what they're thinking. But when you ground data meetings and analysis in student work and what they're putting on paper, that's the closest it gets for you to really understand what concepts they're struggling with, what they know, what they think is true about a certain standard or concept.
When we're really zooming into the student work, it allows us to categorize what the errors are and what the misconceptions could be. And then us as teachers, thinking back as we taught this lesson maybe a month ago, or maybe we just assessed on it last week, we're thinking about how we taught. Maybe we weren't clear in what our directives were.
Okay, we have some really solid no's and do's. Now what we're gonna do is we're going to look at a student exemplar. This is Solomon's, and I want you to pay attention to the two strategies that he used, which is the equations and then the area model. So as you look at this exemplar, think about which no's or do's does this student have mastery of?
Just in the beginning of the packet, I noticed that some of them either opted out of using the area model or are not understanding or not accurately representing the place value of the digits in the multi-digit numbers.
Can you give us an example?
On the back of the front page, we have number one where it says find the product of 3,649 times 6. Mm-hmm. They simply just place the numbers, the digits, into the boxes for the area model without decomposing them or representing the place value that each digit represents.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
There's an aha moment that happens during the data meetings. And so what happens is teachers are able to now understand the errors the students are making. Once we have this data meeting and we unpack the standard, we unpack the no's and do's, and they're able to see that they don't have to reteach the entire lesson, but to zone in on a particular skill as a focus area. And so that gives teachers the tools that they need to practice with. And so when they go into practice, they're able to roll it out the way they would in front of scholars.
What we know to be effective is that when teachers practice the reteach, the student gaps are closed quicker. With your co-teacher, you're going to just practice this. You actually physically have the two samples present as if you were in front of students right now. Okay, our lead teachers are gonna go first.
What do you notice about both of these students' work?
I'm gonna stop you. So what you want to stamp is just this part, because we don't know if this is a gap yet.
And with it being bi-weekly, with the content and data meetings themselves being weekly, we're fixing those gaps almost immediately. So we're not waiting until the end of the year or till the end of the month to say, oh, scholars learned a whole unit and these are the multiple gaps that they have, and now we have to plug and chug when we can. Now we're just literally going back, looking at their assessments and getting right back in there so that the scholars are still familiar with what it is, what the content is that we've taught or now that we're reteaching. Going into reteach after a data meeting, I feel confident, which is key for me as a teacher. We've just discussed explicitly what the error is and how to reteach or how it should be addressed to the scholars. Okay, scholars, so we struggled yesterday when we were doing multi-digit multiplication. We struggled with using our area model. So we have two scholars work. Both of them use their area models and the U.S. standard algorithm.
You hear prompt for place value.
Mm-hmm. And then what do you notice is the difference? What do you notice is the difference? If we're looking at a whole number and we know that using our area model, we need to focus on place value, what do you notice is the difference between these two scholars' work?
There was a whole feedback train kind of happening in the reteach where I was present, I was watching with Katie, me and Katie were watching the teacher, me and Katie conferred and figured out that there was something happening with a key term not being punched, and so I whispered that to Katie. Katie jumped in, model for the teacher. Teacher picked it back up. When students see that, they understand that that is the growth mindset that a learner has, and they apply it to their own thinking and their own practice and become smarter because of it.
In front of scholars, I give you feedback all day, and now you see me taking the feedback from my bosses, from my teachers. And so speaking with one of my scholars, we reflected on how that lets us know that everybody makes mistakes. Everybody has room to grow. Everybody has room to be better. And so that right there lets me push them even more because they see me being pushed.
I feel determined and motivated to like do better because when they come in, that means that like they are observing the classroom. They are trying to make the classroom better and find mistakes to make them better so that we can do what we need to do.
Right now, Ms. Brooks is going to give you a problem. When you go back to work, you need to represent and decompose the place values using your area model. What are you gonna do, Ivan?
We're gonna solve the problem and decompose the number using our area models.
So when I see you decompose, 3,742.
As I was aggressive monitoring, myself and my co, as well as my IL team, we were going around looking for specific errors and using those errors to navigate how to prompt each student and navigating what the error was or what skill it was that they were missing. So each of them are getting the individual prompting that they need in order to get to the mastery that they deserve for that skill.
It's just a really cool experience to be able to see a teacher go from a data meeting to then this being just part of their habits.
And that's ultimately how we're achieving such strong results here, because we're so tuned in to our students and how they learn and what they need and making the adjustments that we need to make as the adults, as the teachers, to support that process.